The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, Unu Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
By the dead air.
Oh, hi. Welcome to Rock Talk. So, how's your week been this week, Jim?
Good. Not that else changed, but it's been fine.
Been okay. Right on. I was listening to Val's show. It's interesting, all the things that she was talking about tonight. It was really cool.
You listened to the whole thing, yeah?
I didn't listen to the whole thing. I couldn't. But I'll definitely tune in more. I like Val. She's a sweetheart. Hey, Val. Hope you're doing well. So, interesting week. It's been a long one for me. So, it's been real, but I have been productive. I've gotten a lot of good stuff done. And we've picked out some different music for tonight. It's not just one type of rock and roll. It's a little mixture. Wouldn't you say so, Jim?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Got from Billy Idol.
A little more eclectic.
Yeah, eclectic. Well, that's the kind of week I've had. A little of this, a little of that. I've been super tired. Anemia is not something that's fun. But there's some exciting things going on this weekend around the Sacramento area and Davis at the Mondavi Center. Singer named Alan Cumming. He's going to be singing some sappy songs on March 31st. That's his promo, not mine. It must be love songs. But a lot of people like that, so you can go check him out there, 6 p.m. at the Mondavi Center. And then Silos, Sheila E., 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Tickets are $30 online, $40 at the door. And that's going to be a spectacular show. It's Beyond the Stage. It's the one that I go to every month. And I hope to see you there. Tickets are limited. Seating is, there's about 30 seats. And this show is selling out fast. And that is going to be on the... Yeah, because it's not per se a concert. What it is, it's Beyond the Stage. And my friend Roman Guzman, who is the head disc jockey in the morning for The River out of Modesto, he interviews different musicians. And we get to hear about all their adventures, all their history with different groups, things that they like, things that have inspired them. And then if we're really lucky, then they do a few songs for us. And it's a really amazing time. It's something that's very different. Every musician that has done this has said that they've never done anything like this before. And they're really enjoying it. It's very personable. It's an intimate time. It's just a great time. And then the benefit of it is you get to meet them, you get to talk to them, you get to see that they're human, they're not just idle, they're people, and it's really a great thing. I really have enjoyed it. I've felt like a little kid at Christmas time, especially when I met Tony Levin, just an amazing bass player. He's played with Peter Gabriel, John Lennon, I mean, everybody. The list is very, very long. So, and then I got to meet Dweezil Zappa. I get a little more of a perk than most people because I'm friends with Roman, and then afterwards I get to hang out with the musicians. So that's cool. And then, like, a couple weeks ago, I was hanging out with Greg Kinn and Robert Barry, and they're just phenomenal. What talent. And what a character Greg is. My God, he had me cracking up laughing. At one point, I just wanted to stand up and cheer because his stories were hilarious. Just a really great time. And then he played four songs off his new album, and it's really good. I encourage everybody to go out and pick yourself up a copy of it. It's Greg Rekindled Band, which I love the play on words there. So it's really good stuff. You won't be disappointed. And you can hear some of the stuff on the Rock and Thrash Talk Facebook page. I've put up a few of his videos, so you can check it out there. And what else do we have going on? It's my Rock and Thrash Talk page on Facebook. So it's where I put concert calendars. I talk about the show that I'm doing now with you. Yeah, it's all about rock and roll. The hard stuff, the medium stuff, and the kind of the date stuff. I don't know. You know what I like. You can't get me not to love my metal.
Exactly.
It's the best thing ever. It is. It's totally the best. You know why? Because it's not going to make you feel bad. Not going to make you think about somebody who left you or a broken anything. You know, it's cool.
I can see heavy metal soothing you, but I can't see headbanging. That's the party. You know what I mean? That's what gets you going, not soothing you.
Yeah. Well, I like mosh pits and I like headbanging, and I guess it's strange for a woman to be talking like that or have that in her that's what
you
she
obviously
likes.
Haven't got your head headbanged enough.
I've repaired plenty of them in my day, you know. Yeah, certainly in that arena. But yeah, I mean, mosh pits back in the day were a little more violent, and I guess it depends on what show you're going to be at. Like if you're going to Exhumed or Slayer, but like King Diamond, he's really hardcore, and you don't really have that thrashing about. It's usually young males, and you know what? They have that aggression in them, and it's a positive out. You know, source to where they can get it out of their system. They can enjoy the music. I think it's a win-win, definitely. Next week's show, even though we just started this week's show, I want to talk about next week's show because I'm compiling a list. I want people to send me songs with a woman's name in the title. So that is going to be the theme of next week. Yeah. So any song with a woman's name.
Maybelline.
Yeah, there's quite a few out there. And in every genre. I try to keep it away from country, even though there is a lot of country that I do appreciate. I just love rock and roll. And I love female rock and rollers. There are so many wonderful, talented women of rock and roll. I actually just got a book. I went to a donation center over the week because I was cleaning out some closets. And I had a whole bunch of stuff to donate. And of course, I spy a whole big thing of books. You know, it's a giant shelf. And there it was. It was just winking at me. It was like, buy me, buy me. I got it for like $2. It's called She's a Rebel. And it's all the women in the history of women in rock and roll. So I suggest you go out and get yourself a copy or go to the library because it's really, really good. It's pretty thick, but it's got a lot of good information. And it's just educating me, too, more on the things that I love and things that we can talk about. So, yeah, who's your favorite female rock and roller?
Of all time, I would say Stevie Nicks.
Yeah, she's pretty phenomenal. Very, very good. You know, I have never, ever
seen... But I've
seen...
gone back to the Motown, the women there.
Yeah.
It goes back, but the most significant, I think, was Stevie Nicks.
Yeah. She's a beautiful person, inside and out. You know, I know we've touched on this subject quite a bit on the show as far as how music is generated and put together. And I know just the relationship issues in Fleetwood Mac inspired so many wonderful songs. I mean, some really good music there. And that is going to be something that's lost when you have people that are in groups that don't even relate face-to-face. They do their bit, and they send it, and then it's all digitally mastered.
Right, which is, it's fake. It comes out plastic. If it, you know what I mean? You look at a steel, and you're getting plastic.
Yeah, you know, I really feel that way. I feel that something is definitely going to be missing, and I want to inspire people to...
The inspiration of music, I mean, just with the people in the same room, inspires, you know what I mean? It pushes them up to a level. You know, you play as good as the person you're playing with, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And you know what it is, too, is just enjoying so much live music in my life and seeing the same bands over and over again. They can play a song that I've heard numerous times, but every single time when it's live, it's different because they bring a different energy back and forth. And that's why I love live music. It's just, it's such an amazing thing to go and watch. You just get out of yourself. You kind of check out from your problems. You leave the day to its own, and you just chill out, and hopefully you're with somebody that you enjoy being around. Like my friend Byron, he's treated me so many times to just amazing shows. We're going to go to a few over the summer, and he's like the best person to go to a show with. He's really intelligent. He has a lot to say. We have good conversation. And he has good taste in music. And, yeah, we totally enjoy all kinds of different genres. We've seen from, the last one was the Bridge School Benefit Concert, when we saw Roger Waters and Neil Young, and then Metallica, Guns N' Roses. We're going to go see Iron Maiden, and I am so excited about that. I've talked about that endlessly, but I'm so excited about it. I haven't seen them since 1989, and I was not even drinking age back then. So, yeah. So it's going to be fun. I'll have to get you a t-shirt and send it off to you.
Iron Maiden. I couldn't even tell you what they sing.
Oh my God, they are so great. And Bruce Dickinson, of course, he is a survivor of cancer, just like myself. So it's kind of like a kindred thing that he and I have. I would love to be able to meet him. He's also a pilot.
Is this the English guy there? Yes, I just saw something on him.
Guess what? We have a caller.
All right.
Extension 6 to accept, press 1. To send a voicemail, press 2. To hear the phone number, press 3.
They called me, my first caller.
You hit 1 for accept?
Accept, press 1.
Okay. Hi, welcome to Rock Talk. You're on the air.
Okay.
Hello, hello.
Somebody trying to get through.
Yeah.
All right, let's do the three songs.
Okay. First thing we have up is Blackbird by the Beatles. That's probably my favorite Beatles song. And then we're going to play...
It's funny, you've got Bob Dylan. That's my favorite Bob Dylan song, Tangled
Up
in the Blue. Yeah.
I think it's one of my top favorites, too. Oh, they're calling back. Let's hold off for a second. Hi, you're on the air. Welcome to Rock Talk.
I'm glad to be here.
Hi.
Nice to talk to you, Amy.
Hey, is this Nathan?
Yeah, this is Nathan with It's Nacho Truck. It's mine.
All right. Wonderful. So Nathan's calling in and letting us know where his food truck's going to be in the Sacramento area this weekend. So where are you going to be?
All right. Well, I mean, starting off Thursday, we have a big event going on. It's a lunchtime event, but it's for the announcement of the upcoming Concert in the Park concert series. So we'll be at Cesar Chavez from 11 to 1.
On
Thursday, Saturday, we will be doing the River City Market at Fremont Park, which is 1515 Q Street, down in the heart of Midtown Sacramento. Should be an awesome event. And then that evening, we'll be doing the season opener of the Sac Republic football club or soccer team over there at what was the Bonnie Field. I don't know what the new name is, but we'll be there from 5 to 9. And then Sunday, we will be in Woodland serving the people up there some amazing gourmet nachos just in the heart of downtown Woodland off First Street.
Wow.
And that's from 4 to 8.
Sounds like a really busy weekend and some really cool events going on. So tell me, Nathan, what is your signature nacho? Which one is the most famous that you make?
I mean, all pretty popular, but I got to tell everybody, I mean, if you're looking for 7-Eleven or ballpark nachos, I'm not the person to come to see. I'm not your man, okay?
Well, of course.
We do house-made white corn chips, gluten-free, or over fries now. That's a new option as well. But right now, I mean, our braised chicken is the most popular. All of our cheeses are made from scratch. They're beer-based cheese sauces.
Wow.
So I have a Pabst and sharp cheddar cheese sauce. And also, for the gluten-free people out there, I have a Angry Orchard hard cider Fontina cheese sauce. And then right now, though, the special I'm running, it's called Heart and Soul. And it's a Korean-style bulgogi beef tri-tip with Asian pears, kimchi-infused beer cheese, and it has a green onions on it and a sriracha cream as well. So,
man, that sounds really good. I'm getting hungry just listening to that. I'm going to have to come out and check it out and hang out with you a little bit.
Yeah, look forward to it.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. Your truck is really pretty, too. It's all colorful, purples and greens. I really like it. I like the style of it.
Yeah, it's sort of a shag, like the artist shag style of like SoCal, sort of that same motif.
Yeah, yeah. And Midtown is a great, great place to hang out, too. There's so many little pubs and clubs to check out, and the nightlife's really picking up, and the weather's going to be great this weekend.
Yeah, the weather's supposed to finally be gorgeous. It's been a really rough winter. We needed the rain, don't get me wrong, but as a food truck owner, the rain is the death to us, but, you know, we appreciate the rain, but yeah, like you said, Midtown is very eclectic, and has its own little niche for every type of person out there, so, I mean, if you come out and get food, you can definitely know that there's going to be that little bar or that pub or somewhere to get good wine or, you know. Or
even the artists.
Coffee house to go to as well.
Yeah, the local artists that you can go check out too. That's just amazing. So much to do. It makes me want to live out there.
Yeah, well, I mean, we'd love for you to live out here, but, you know, you have your family and your wife out there, so.
Yeah. Well, it's not so far. 20 minutes.
It's not too far.
And then you drive so fast. Well, I do. Probably shouldn't.
Right.
But, you know, can't go
from... You got to get to where you're going.
Yes, yeah, but you can't take the ambulance out of the girl, right? I mean,
that's true, right?
Once you're behind the wheel of that, Nothing's ever the same.
Yeah, well, it'll be our secret. I mean, I drive a little fast, too, even in the truck. But, you know, I'm excited to go to the events I'm going to and to see the people that I'm going to see.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Keith Breedlove's in Las Vegas now for a few days.
He's doing the restaurant and bar show, I believe. He's out there with John Taffer and, you know, doing his big things. His head shaved now after his donation. And
he looks great, too. And he and Amy are just two really awesome people. What a pleasure to have them in my life.
Yeah, if anybody can pull it off, he can. You know, personality about everything else, you know, so he can pull any look off. So.
Yeah, even in adversity, he's got a smile on his face, and he's like, yeah, well, let's move on, move it along. Yeah. We'll make the best of it. And
absolutely.
That's the kind of person that you want to be around. People that lift you up and not weigh you down. So, well, I really appreciate you calling in, Nathan. And I will text you later, and I will probably see you this weekend.
All right. I look forward to it. Have a great night.
You too, sweetie. Talk to you later. Bye.
Right, bye.
Well, that was Nathan. So that's great. He's a nacho guy.
Nacho Nathan.
Yeah. I mean, that doesn't even sound like like nachos. I haven't tried them, but I've seen them. And now that I'm actually eating more. But I did, Jim, doing that Whole30 for 40 days. You know, I lost almost 7 pounds, and my labs were spectacular. They were really good.
What's labs?
My labs, my blood work, my cholesterol, and yeah, it was all really good, except that I found out that, you know, I have this anemia, so I'm not just depressed, no.
What, your mother? I'm your mother. My mother had I'm thinking anemic, same thing?
Yeah, it's the same thing.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. I've been really tired, but you know how hyper I am anyhow, but I was just like, God, I don't feel very well. But I couldn't pinpoint it. And even after going to the doctors, I didn't even really talk to her about that. And then she's like, you don't have enough blood in your body. I'm like, is that what's wrong? So, but I think with some maybe more supplements or something, hopefully that's all that it is. So I'm not too worried about it, and I actually do feel better. I just haven't done any of my CrossFit for the past like 3 weeks, almost a month now, but I'll get back on the horse, you know? So let's get back into the music, or start the music anyhow, with Blackbird by the Beatles, Tangled Up in Blue by Bob Dylan, Don't Tell Me You Love Me by Night Ranger. So those are our first three.
Singing in the dead of night, take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night, take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the line of a dark black night. Black night. in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You are only waiting for this moment to arise. You are only waiting for this moment to arise. You are only waiting for this moment to arise.
The sun was shining, I was laying in bed, wondering if she'd changed at all, if her hair was still red. Her folks, they said our lives together sure was gonna be rough. They never did like mama's homemade dress, papa's bank book wasn't big enough. And I was standing on the side of the road, rain falling on my shoes, heading out for the East Coast. Lord knows I paid some dues getting through, tangled up in blue. She was married when we first met, soon to be divorced. I helped her out of a jam, I guess, but I used a little too much force. We drove that car as far as we could, abandoned it out west, split up on the docks at night, but the green it was best. She turned around to look at me as I was walking away. I heard her say over my shoulder, we'll meet again someday on the avenue, tangled up in blue. I had a job in the Great North Woods, working as a cook for a spell, but I never did like it all. And one day the axe just fell. So I drifted down to New Orleans, where I lucky with a be employed, working for a while on a fishing boat right outside of Delacroix. But all the while I was alone, the past was close behind. I seen a lot of women, but she never escaped my mind. And I just grew this place, and I stopped in for a beer. I just kept looking at the side of her face in the spotlight so clear. And later on when the crowd thinned out, I was just about to do the same. She was standing there in back of my chair. I said, Timmy, don't I know your name? I murdered something underneath my breath. She studied the lines on my face. I must admit, felt a little uneasy when she bent down to tie the laces of my shoes. Pray. I thought you'd never say hello, she said, you look like a silent type. Then she opened up a book of poems and handed it to me, written by an Italian poet from the 13th century. And every one of them words rang true and glowed like burning coal, pouring off of every page like it was written in my soul from me to you. Down the stairs, there was music in the cafes at night and revolution in the air. Then he started into dealing with slaves and something inside of him died. She had to sell everything she owned and froze up inside. And when it finally the bottom fell out, I became withdrawn. The only thing I knew how to do was to keep on keeping on like a bird that flew. To get to her somehow. All the people we used to know that
I don't know what they do with their lives, but me, I'm still on the road, heading for another joint. We always did feel the same, we just saw it from a different point of view. We'll be right back.
Hey, Dan. How's the day going so far?
My day? Couldn't be better. You pull up less than 3 minutes after I open my Lyft app, and how do you greet me? With a kind hello? Just delightful.
Great. Care for a cookie?
A cookie? A cookie? A chocolate chip cookie? You know, I'd love one.
Sure.
Hey, let me ask you something. How did you know I love this song?
I mean, come on, it's the Cold War kids. Everybody loves them.
Whoa! Who taught this guy how to merge? That was a fantastic merge!
Couldn't agree more.
That's it? That's all this costs? What's this thing running on? Smiles and high fives? You son of a bike! I love you!
Thanks. Have a great day.
Lyft. Driving you happy. Just download and go.
Tune in to Rock Talk Tuesdays and Thrash Talk Thursdays with me, Aimster, and company. 8 p.m. Pacific, 11 p.m. Eastern on Armed Radio Global, home of Night Talk with Joe Rocks.
Hello, welcome back to Rock Talk. I hope you enjoyed those three songs. Blackbird by the Beatles, Tangled Up in Blue by Bob Dylan, and then we have Don't Tell Me You Love Me by Night Ranger. So, I've seen two of the groups, well, Bob Dylan and Night Ranger, have not seen the Beatles, and of course we can't do that. But
seen
they are
Paul
one
McCartney,
of the greatest.
Seen Ringo Starr.
Yeah. Yeah. My dog's name was Ringo. Well, he's not my dog anymore. I gave him to a woman about a month and a half ago. I gave him away because this woman has some medical issues, and she needed a smart dog, and her dog had a stroke and died, and she was just really distraught about it. And I thought, you know what? I know Ringo would really light up her life. And so, guess what? They're inseparable now. And he just got certified as her new service dog, and he is just loving being able to work. So
you gave your dog?
I did. I gave up I just had a feeling that he could help her, and he just fell in love. And she actually was having a party, not so much a party. Well, it turned into a party, but she was having like a celebration of life for her dog, because he was fairly not old, but had been in her life quite some time. And so I guess the passing of him was untimely, and so she was having this celebration for him. And I guess he was really loved by her friends and family, and so I gave her Ringo, and all these people started bringing him gifts. So I mean, he hit the lottery with Sandra, let me tell you. And she sends me pictures. I can go see him anytime I want. And you know, I love him, but he's definitely getting star treatment. You know, he's spoiled rotten now. He has his own carriage. Ridiculous.
Yeah, you can't compete with that.
I know, it's just like, I can't compete. But, you know, I'm happy for both of them. So, that's good. I know my cat ran away. I don't know.
Male? Female?
Yeah, a couple years ago. Well, he's been fixed since I got him. I've had both my cats for... they're about 9 years old now. They're brother and sister. The first time I lost one of them, I don't know what happened, but Belle, my black cat, she was gone for about 4 months. And, you know, every few days I'd go to the pound and look. And black cats have a hard time. There's a actual big room in the back of the shelters, and it's nothing but black cats. So if you go do adopt, you should go look for a black cat, because a lot of them are euthanized. They don't get as much love as the other cats, and they're just as smart and beautiful as the others. So, but I wound up finding her, and
discrimination.
Yeah, well, it is, and you know, my cat is. Well, I think there's a lot of
Black Lives Matter.
Well, they think maybe witches own them, or
yeah, it's bad luck,
or they're bad luck, or whatever.
Yeah. It's not that the people fail; it's just cats are bad luck.
But they're not. I've had three black cats in my life.
They're no different than any other cat.
Exactly.
You know, they're no
correct.
Different.
But I wound up finding her, and she was sitting at the doorstep of a house that I had lived in before. And it was so weird. And her collar was on. And it was just like, it was just weird. I was so thrilled to get her back. And yeah, she's home. But similar thing happened with her brother. He wound up going missing. And I thought, oh my God, somebody stole him because he's such a lover. Well, about 4 months, 5 months, I get this phone call from this old man saying, I don't know, what about this cat? You know, he's been hanging around my house, and I just looked, and this is your phone number, and is he your cat? Well, of course he's going to be my cat. You know, it's got my contact information. So I was thrilled to get that phone call. But when I went to go pick him up, he was 13 miles away, up in the English hills, all right, in this gorgeous mansion. I walk in this place, my cat sprawled out on a leather sofa, watching like a 52-inch screen flat TV, watching the game with the man of the house, and I thought, oh my God, and I said, this is a total upgrade, but you're coming home. I actually felt guilty for coming to get my cat.
Yeah, because usually in houses like that, they don't get much attention, that's for sure. They're just a ornament.
Yeah, these people seemed fairly loving, and there were other cats, but I couldn't figure out, now, how the hell did he get up there? He had to have, you know, walked down the highway, or I think maybe somebody picked him up and took him out there. I don't know. Your guess is as good as mine, but I'm just happy he's home. So.
Sounds great.
Yeah. You have your two cats, right?
Yes, I do.
Peggy Sue
and Sally Sue.
Peggy Sue and Sally Sue. Awesome. I love cats. I love dogs, too.
I've had cats all my life since we were kids, because we had a shed out there, and there was a family of wild cats. She had a litter. I made my father bring her in. I was only about 5 years old. And he got all scratched up. But ever since then, I've had cats. We ended up taming them.
Yeah, you catch them early and you can. Yep, I love cats.
It's amazing what they ate, because, you know, my mother, we were poor. We grew up poor. So cats was just another, we never had pets because they were another mouth to feed.
Yeah.
13 brothers and sisters.
My God.
But we'll throw them out potatoes.
Wow.
They would eat it. You know, you'd be surprised what a cat would eat. I didn't think they eat vegetables.
Yeah, my cat eats whatever. She's pretty diverse in her taste, too. Yeah, so let's see. What do we have coming up next? We have Seen It All Before,
yep,
by Amos Lee. And Amos Lee is a newer artist. He's kind of folky. I really, really love his work. I'm going to put a couple of his videos up on the Rock and Talk Facebook page. And if you guys want to call in, our call-in number is 1-800-508-5431. You can call in and talk to us if you have an event like Nathan has going with his nacho truck. You can call in and let us know what's going on. Let everybody know in Northern California and, well, actually across the country. So maybe if somebody's vacationing out here, too, they could know what's going on. So we're going to be playing Amos Lee, Billy Idol, love Billy Idol, White Wedding, and Bright Lights by Matchbox 20. I'm playing that for Mike, my friend Mike. He's the one that loves that. His little girl, Ella, used to sing it. She was about 3 years old. I can remember her loving that song. So that's for you, Mike. And we'll get back into the music.
Anymore. only one. Hey little sister, who's your Superman? Hey little sister, who's the one you want? Hey little sister, shotgun. It's a nice day to start again. It's a nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again. Hey little sister, who is it you're with? Hey little sister, what's your spicy wish? Hey little sister, shotgun, oh yeah. Hey little sister, who's your Superman? Hey little sister, shotgun. It's a nice day to start again. It's a nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again.
A picture of me. city. But some things in this world, man, they don't make sense. But some things you don't need until they leave you. Then the things that you miss, you say, baby, 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 when all your love is gone, who will save me from all I'm up against out in this world? But if the bright lights don't receive you, you should turn yourself around and come on home. Let that city take you in. Come on. Let that city spit you out. Come on. Let that city take you down. Yeah. For God's sakes, turn around. The bright lights don't receive you.
Hi guys, this is Steve Moulton, your favorite convenience store clerk from a little movie called Sharknado, reminding you to keep your pepper jack fresh, but more importantly, tune in to Talk Time with Val every Tuesday night from 7 o'clock to 9 o'clock on ARM Radio.
And now, another fresh insight from Roger Berkowitz, President and CEO of Legal Seafoods.
If your wife can't take the time to test your tuna for purity, then why should you take the time to come to a complete stop before letting her out of the car? Just saying.
Legal Seafoods. If it isn't fresh, it isn't legal.
Hey, welcome back to Rock Talk. Hope you enjoyed those three songs. I'm glad you're a fan of Matchbox 20, Jim. That's really cool. I think they're underrated band. Yeah, I really like them. They haven't come out with anything lately, though, have they? I haven't seen anything.
No, like I said, he went on his own for a bit, and that was the end of it.
Yeah.
I forget his name.
Rob Thomas?
Rob Thomas, that's it.
Rob, right?
Rob, yep.
Yeah. Do you have your sound on, because I can hear myself echoing.
Thanks for reminding me.
It's okay. That's what friends are for, right?
Yeah, I got carried away.
It's okay. So once again, I'm going to talk about Sheila E., the world-class drummer, percussionist, singer, songwriter, entertainer, author, humanitarian. She's a mentor, an actress, a musical powerhouse. That's what she is. She's worked with Ringo Starr, who we just talked about. Well, we talked about my dog, Ringo. Marvin Gaye. And, of course, she's most well-known for working with Prince and Beyoncé. And then Herbie Hancock, Diana Ross, Lionel Richie, Gloria Estefan, George Duke, so many, so many more. She's recorded 7 solo albums. She's acted in several films. And yeah, so I'm going to be meeting her. Roman Guzman is going to be interviewing her at Silos on the 9th of April. Time is 5 to 7 p.m. Tickets, advance tickets are $30-$40 at the door. So the event is a speaking engagement. And then what happens is she'll probably play a couple songs and then talk to the audience afterwards, and we get to meet her, maybe get an autograph. So love to see you. Get your tickets in advance. It sells out pretty fast because it's a small venue. And it's unlike anything else that you've ever been to. So you should check it out. Go to my Rock and Thrash Talk. I don't even know the name of my own page. and give it a like, share, and I always have all the current events going on. So there's lots of info on that page for you. So check it out, and we're going to be playing some Nora Jones, some Modern English, and some Cowboy Junkies. Is that what we have coming up?
Exactly.
Right on. Okay, so let's get back into the music.
All right.
As I sit and watch the snow falling down. I don't miss you at all. I hear children playing, laughing so loud. I don't think of your smile. So if you never come to me, you'll stay a distant man. Out my window, I see lights going dark. Your dark eyes don't haunt me. And then I wonder who I am without the warm touch of.
I want to tell you all about an amazing salon, Joyce's, located at 132 Ferry Street in Everett, Massachusetts. Joyce's specializes in the latest techniques in coloring, styling, cutting, and beach waves. Joyce's features Sukesha all-natural nutrient products and organic color. Joyce's full-service spa and salon, located at 132 Ferry Street, Everett, Massachusetts. 617-387-6688. Specializing in you.
Welcome back to Rock Talk. That is so awesome, Jim. So on the break, Jim just, we were talking about some trivia about Nora Jones and who her father is. So tell everybody who her father is.
Ravi Shankar.
Nice. That's crazy. That is crazy. I had no idea.
He's big in the Monterey Pop, Woodstock era.
Wow.
He played a sitar or whatever the Indian instrument.
It's a sitar.
Sitar, yeah.
Yeah, I want to learn how to play a sitar. I love Indian people. The women are beautiful. They're just, I've never met one that wasn't just really, really nice. and just kind people. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. And the sitar, amazing. When I was a little girl and I lived in Marin with my mom, she was in college, and our next door neighbor was an Indian woman, and she was married to a man. I always thought he looked like Sonny Bono. And when I think about them, I think of like Sonny and Cher, because she kind of looked like that. But she played the sitar, and it was so beautiful. Yeah, it was really, really cool. There's so many string instruments that are just amazing.
Yeah, that the mandolin.
Yeah. I really want to focus this year on learning more on the guitar. That's what Tony said to me when we were sitting there talking, Tony Levin. He says, you got a lot of energy. You got to learn to sit down because you're like my wife all over the place. I'm like, yeah, if I could learn just focus on stuff, that would help me tremendously.
Speaking of bass players, see, I don't know how songs are written, but I've only known what Mick Jagger said. He says, when he writes a song, first thing they do is they come together with the bass player and the drummer. They come up with a track.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, they either add electric or he starts with the vocals.
Okay.
And that's where they rock from. So when they start making an album, first thing they do is bring in the bass player and the drummer. And let them come up with riffs, whatever, however they call it that way, but that's what they start with.
Yeah.
Now we're talking Mick Jagger and Keith Richards couldn't write a song for the life of them. All right, when they started, all they did was copies.
Okay.
All right.
I didn't realize they were a cover band.
Paul McCartney and John Lennon told him, get in the room and don't come out until you got a song. And he did, and I forget what the name of the song was, the first Stone song that they come out with.
Well, we're going to have to...
It'll come to me.
Yeah. When I was talking to Dweezil Zappa, he was talking about stuff along those lines, and how the black page, he was touching on that piece of music that was written. And it was written as a drum solo, and then he was trying to convert it into guitar. And his father was such a pioneer in the different notes and ways you can play the guitar. He was putting different amps together. And Dweezil was saying, you know, he's running chords all over the place. And now, this day and age, you have, you know, the pedals that do all those effects. But his dad was doing it, you know, just by different types of amplifiers. So it's really cool. But the black, I think the Black Page is what it's called. Yeah, the Black Page by Frank Zappa. It's probably the most hard piece of music to play. And there's, like, in one note, he'll have, like, three notes in one. I don't know. The way he was explaining it, I guess you'd have to be there. But that's another thing. You can watch the video. I think you could even buy the interview with him that we did a couple months ago. Very interesting. He also runs like a guitar camp in New York, and he hires different guitarists to come in and teach everybody different skill levels. You know, you could be a kid just learning, or maybe you're 50 or 60 or whatever. You know, it doesn't matter. Maybe you've been playing your whole life. So there's different people that'll help you. I'd love to be able to go to that. I mean, it sounds so awesome. And I think you should always strive to learn something. And if it's something that you've held on to, like from being a kid, and it's still an interest of yours, you definitely need to pursue it. Right?
Go what you like, because that's the only way you'll be happy.
Yep, and you have to make yourself happy. That's no one else's job. And you know what makes me happy? Star Wars trivia makes me happy. So, nobody's answered a couple of these questions that I've asked over the weeks. I want to know if anybody out there knows what species Yoda was. So, if you know that...
Would you say Yoda?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, if you know the answer to that, then put your answers on the Rock and Thrash Talk page. You can message me there. Yeah, because I want to know. I don't know what it is. I don't know the answer. So, who was the person who uttered the words, "Luke, don't give in to hate"? Does anybody know that?
I do now. I do now.
Don't answer that.
I never watched the movie and I can answer it.
Okay. Well, you have four choices. Was it Princess Leia, Han Solo, Yoda, or Obi-Wan Kenobi? So, A, B, C, or D. So those are two questions. If anybody knows the answer to that, I will put you in the drawing for the monthly prize, which is pretty darn cool. Yeah. Some nice stuff that I have here to give away. What's going to go on? Let's see. What day is that? On the 31st of March, there is a Pink Floyd Laser Spectacular show, and that is at Ace of Spades in Sacramento, and I am going to it. I am so looking forward to that. That is going to be one amazing show. You can get your tickets online. Yep, you can get your tickets online, and it starts at 6 p.m. on Friday. So be there, be square. I'm also going to go see Roger Waters June 12th at the Golden One Center, and that starts at 8 p.m. Tickets are on sale now. That'll sell out. It might even be sold out by now. And what an amazing artist he is. My God, he was phenomenal at the Bridge School Benefit concert. I loved it. I have a couple of the videos posted on the Facebook page. So, I really wish you were out here. You'd come and go to these things with me, Jim.
I'd like California again. Definitely visit.
Yeah.
How come I'm tricking your mind again?
Is your... I haven't touched
any... No, my tape is saying off.
Well, I don't know what it is. I'm going to put the black page, the video of Frank Zappa playing that on the Rock and Thrash Talk page. That'll be really cool. You can check it out. It's really an intense piece of music. So, yeah, how's your weather this week?
Good. Rain. No snow.
Oh, good. You're getting better. You're getting better.
Yes, we are.
We have had no rain. Well, yeah, actually, we did have rain. I take that back. Like 3 days ago, we had rain. Yeah. I had to clean the gutters of this damn house. My God. But I've been so weak, I can't even push the lawnmower. So, I don't know. I'm going to have to buy some Wheaties and eat some of those, see if that does the trick, right?
That'll go.
Yeah. So, let's see. What do we have next? We have Rock Lobster by the B-52s. And we have After the Fire... and then we have Friday, I'm in Love by The Cure. Those are some great songs. So let's get back into the music.
All right.
let you know on the TV and the radio. She was young, her heart was pure, but every night it's bright she got. She said sugar sweet, she got me rapping to the beat, then I knew that she was hot. She was singing, don't turn around.
company went under a dock, and there they saw a rock. It wasn't a